Welcome to this week's astrology report with me, April Shaley, your astrologer. Today's date is the 15th of December. We're headed toward Yule. We're headed toward winter solstice or summer solstice for those of you in the South. Hi, guys. Sun's going to move into Capricorn. These are moments where, you know, when the sun moves into a new sign, first of all, the sun sort of tells us what season it is, what the flavor of this time is. Moving into one of these cardinal signs, going into that 0 degree mark of these cardinal signs, it is a change, a bigger change. And so the chart for that moment is important. So the sun is going to be conjunct or fused together with its ruling, what will be its ruling planet when it moves into Capricorn, which is Saturn, otherwise known as Satan, right? Saturn is incarnation. Becoming meat, right? Becoming matter, Mother Earth. Capricorn's a feminine sign. Saturn in the Kabbalah, the tree of life, is Bina, the divine feminine, the divine mother. That's the, you know, you go up the tree to the left, that's the left-hand path going all the way up there. Now, of course, you have to, there's all sorts of other pathways you can take, but my point is that this left-hand path is this relationship that we have with our bodies and the spiritual relationship, how we get direct gnosis through being embodied. Now it has a sinistre, I mean left, right, has this reputation for evil because we're in, or we have been through this age of Pisces, you know, we've been in this, we're sort of tilted toward the right-hand path, but that when we go too far to the right-hand path, what happens is, yes, there's meaning and compassion and we appreciate what's beyond the world, but we also become disembodied and perhaps self-righteous and judgmental and lose connection with the feminine, with the body, with the currents of magic and the beauty of the seasons and the connection to things like astrology become demonized, you know, because it has to do with the seasons. Things like spell work become demonized. Things like witchcraft become demonized, you know, just working with herbs and healing people, you know, people have been burned at the stake for this reason, because there's this disembodiment, the body and sexuality and the feminine within all of us, not just women. Well, the women get targeted for this, certainly, but the Lilithian nature is demonized. And we lose our sense of the holiness of the body and again, sexuality, and sexuality being a vehicle for gnosis, for direct gnosis. So Capricorn speaks to that. Capricorn speaks to our embodiedness and matter and why matter matters. And also what we do to, how we relate to society. So it has to do with how we interface with the world and what we offer the world. So it has to do with status. It has to do with, its keywords are I use. Like, how do we use our bodies? How do we use what's around us to make something tangible rather than dreaming about it only? So it has to do with grounding our vision into manifestation. Now the next sign over is Aquarius, which has to do with this larger vision, and things become more, less and less embodied as the zodiac moves on. So this is sort of this pinnacle of physical achievement happens in Saturn or Capricorn. Saturn's the ruling planet. So it is the midheaven in the chart, the top of the chart, the top of the tree, the part of the tree that everybody sees, right? So it has to do with reputation. So Saturn or Capricorn both really have to do with reputation. And so, and responsibility, the ability to respond to what is and to manifest it. How do we manifest? Like, if you want to manifest an animal sanctuary, how do you do that? You need money in the bank. You need energy units, sort of Scorpio's world, right? And Taurus's world. You need units of energy that you can transform into resources to support that endeavor. You need to have land. You need to have animals. You need to have the ability to rescue animals to put on the land in the animal sanctuary. We can have our hearts in the right place. But we, again, this is Earth school. So if we're not embodied and we're not able to respond to the needs, you know, to what's necessary to create such a thing, it's just going to stay in our minds, and we can just say, oh, society does this to me, and take on this victim mentality. And that is where the Satan part of this gets, you know, the devil comes into the picture, you know, that we're being tortured by the world and the world sucks and you know, it's all persecuting me. And that's a lack of responsibility when we think like that. It kind of is. Now, I'm not saying that there aren't situations that are, you know, are truly that, you know, when we get too hierarchical, we get too, you know, society can indeed be oppressive. And so there, you know, we need to acknowledge that, of course, as well. So I'm not preaching hierarchy and preaching how, you know, like, I don't want to take responsibility either. I don't want to pay my bills. But that's part of the Saturn thing. So a lot of that kind of heaviness has come into the picture with Mercury conjunct Saturn, with, you know, and the sun's going to conjunct Saturn as it goes into Capricorn at the winter solstice. So there's going to continue to be this sort of heaviness to things as they shift over. But also the other side of it is this ability to connect to the physical and remind ourselves of the beauty of that. And the beauty that's in the imperfection, or the perceived imperfection of the physical world, of the world of matter, of the limitations of it. Like, I was having a discussion with another artist. We're talking about the creation and that sometimes it's really beneficial to an artist to have limitations, to have boundaries, to have a time constraint, to have specific parameters to work within, because otherwise it's all just this open, I don't know, I could do this, I could play, you know, a piano and write a poem and nobody, I don't know, there's no real thing, I have no goal for this, and you know, and you just sort of get lost in possibility. So Saturn can be this grounding influence. So we want to try to use this energy to ground ourselves into a focus. And what, you know, paying attention to what it is that we what's our priority? How do we prioritize what we actually value and put our energy units, money, put our resources, put our time? It's all Saturn governed stuff as well, because it's all that the finiteness, you know, this illusion of finiteness. We know that reality is, of course, much bigger than that. We were never born, we never die. Life is much more than this mortal, you know, we're born, we do some things, we regret them, we, you know, we hit midlife, we try to do it over again, then we get old, we die. Like, that's, you know, we get into this existential angst when we have a lot of Saturn energy going on. So we also don't want to just let Saturn completely take over again. That's when things become, they lose soul. You go too far down the left-hand path, things get pornographic, objectified, soulless. You go too far down the right, again, things get pious, they get self-righteous, they get disembodied, they get, you know, holier than thou, like whatever. So, but, you know, we want to keep things animated, keep the animation of it. That's the magic of things. That's the ensoulment. That's the enchantment of life. And so we have a new moon in Sagittarius that's happening on Sunday at 1:30 a.m. Eastern time. So you can do your time calculations for that wherever you are in the world. And so the new moon is sort of a reset button, and it's a vision-making moon, you know, new moon. And Sag sees far. Sag takes the arrow and shoots it to whatever where Sag wants to go. Sag rules travel, Sag rules journey, Sag rules perception, vision, truth. So this is a moon where we can get a little bit more centered in our truth and what it is that we want to manifest as the winter solstice, the season changes. And new moon, you know, preceding the new moon, like right now, we're getting into the dark moon, and the new moon is a dark sort of time. It's not the full moon where everything's hyped up. The new moon is when we can retreat a bit. The solstice is for that too. Solstice means sun stands still. It's this moment where the sun appears to stand still in the sky, and then starts to go the other direction, and in the north, it's reborn. Right? So there's this time with the new moon and right before the sun's reborn, and at the moment where the sun is reborn, where we can retreat backwards or back before Mercury goes direct, you know, and this is an inventory taking time for us to make decisions about where we want to put our energy going forward, okay? So speaking of the new moon, I do have an exclusive post just for patrons that is going to be posted today. If you would like to be part of that, you want to be able to look at that video, make sure you become a patron at patreon.com, April's Astrology. You can go find that. We'll be doing a divination and a spell, or we're going to be talking about a spell for Yule, how to use that well. And then also, if you missed the Black Friday sale, if you happen to miss that because it did happen fast, you can use the coupon Yule, Y-U-L-E, all caps, at aprilsastrology.com to get a gift or a reading for yourself. There's gift cards available. People get them immediately into their email, so you can do that. And then Mercury goes direct Friday. You know, that's good news, right? We want that to happen. And one thing I wanted to mention before we get into the cards here is Chiron. Chiron makes a square to the sun today. Chiron's the wounded healer, and he's also a centaur like Sag, half horse, half human. So he's kind of this, there's a lot around that right now, this theme of the animal nature, physical nature, meeting the spiritual nature. And it's not like that doesn't happen all the time, but this is a time where I would suggest that we become more aware of that. And Chiron squaring the sun can point out to us sort of where we might feel less than awesome in terms of how we, you know, our self-concept and our identity, and sort of poke a hole in that a little bit. Saturn does that too. So if you're feeling that way, you know, you're not feeling like the most powerful human in the universe, just be aware that that's happening and use it to your benefit. Again, this is a time of retreat. It's a good time for retreat and contemplation and revisioning, so that when Mercury goes direct, and when the sun is reborn, and when the moon goes full, and when things go into you know, the secular new year happens, and it's 2018, we have our vision for that and what we want to see happen, and we're able to move toward that with a lot more clarity. Okay, so let's pick our card for this week. I'm gonna just pull from the Rider deck. And this is the Two of Wands. And this is just what we were just talking about. Visioning. Looking at the globe, looking over the horizon. You know, sometimes when we're like, we're gonna get a big change in life, we'll go out to the ocean and look over, you know, the horizon, and look at the sea. And when we go out into the world, come out of our homes a little bit, even when it's cold, we get a chance to, like, here, I'll hold the card up a little bit more. It sort of opens up our minds to be physically out into, you know, an expansive place, a big field, again, at the sea, looking over the ocean. And he is, you know, the Two Wands are inspiration. And how am I going to take, you know, in the Thoth deck, it's dominion, right? So how do I take control of my life, become a true authority in my own life, and determine my own direction? Wands are fire. This new moon's going to happen in fire, in Sag. So it is an inspired new moon. And I think that we can be inspired in the way that we relate to it going into this next phase of manifesting what we vision, and a new year, a new season, a new opportunity to create what we want to create with more consciousness. And again, I have a spell that I'm going to be sharing with patrons about how to do that. So if you would like to watch that video that I'll be posting shortly, please do become a patron. You'll be able to see it. Okay? So many blessings and take care. Bye now.